America is hot. This is the place to be these days. Americans live longer and better than most anyone else, anywhere else. A survey that claims to measure people's satisfaction with their lives and optimism about the future found Americans rank themselves ahead of every other country.
John, let's talk about Stossel in the classroom. Tell us about what the topics are and what you hope to accomplish in those schools that might get the program.
I've done a number of programs that go on TV. They vanish into the ether, and teachers and sometimes college professors, more often high school teachers, said, oh, I wish I could have taped that. I could teach science to the kids, or I could teach economics, free market economics. And so a charity's now gotten ABC's permission to license these to schools with some text material, and this is my new passion. I'm more excited about this sometimes than doing new stories.
We start our look at what makes a country work well for its people by comparing three places: America, Hong Kong, and India.
Here in India, much of the population lives in what we call slums. This family's home is this abandoned sewer pipe. Many survive by rummaging through garbage. 300 million people here have no running water, nothing clean to drink.
Is it a situation where you believe that it's possible to change the way, on some of the topics, the way that youngsters think?
No, I don't think I can make a real dent in changing the way people think. But I think I can be a jungle gym for the brain and at least let people know they're are other ways of thinking about capitalism and poverty and the lawyer's version of the world. And at least let the kids know, hey, there's another viewpoint out there.
Of course, we all know why India's poor. Too many people. When you have this kind of overpopulation, you can't have a good standard of living. Of course, as so often happens, what we all know isn't necessarily so. Consider Hong Kong. Talk about crowded. Hong Kong, for a square mile, has 20 times as many people as India. Yet, Hong Kong is rich. Amazingly rich.
There are more Rolls Royces in Hong Kong than anywhere else in the world. The harbors are filled with yachts. And the real estate is glorious.
These apartment buildings are home to Hong Kong's new middle class. They're even called the mid-level. Economic freedom has allowed millions of poor people to become middle class. In fact, the average income here now is almost equal to that in the United States, and it's higher than that in many of the world's richest countries.
Not as high as America's 27,000, but almost, and higher than Australia, Italy, Great Britain, and Canada.
Is there one in particular that you're most proud of that you think could have a significant impact?
I think the one most useful for classrooms is one I did called Is America Number One? What made us successful? You got 5 billion people in the world living in the mud of desperate poverty. We, just because we had limited government, rule of law, and otherwise let people alone to use their creative energy and economic freedom to build, we created all this wealth, all this good stuff by having economic freedom and an open society. We created America, and so we know what works. Let's discuss it. Let's discuss why other countries don't do that. And is this the best country?
I was in Hong Kong in the 1950s, and you would never have wanted to live there. I saw the open shacks in which the refugees who were coming over were living. But they had the one key ingredient, freedom.
Freedom. Now, when people say freedom, I usually think of democracy, freedom to elect your representatives. But democracy alone doesn't make a country prosper. India's a democracy. It's similar to ours. Well, maybe a little louder. But they vote for representatives and a prime minister. They have freedom of religion, freedom of speech. Yet the poverty in India shows that democracy alone is not enough. The standard of living here is 1/100 what it is in Hong Kong. Yet
Hong Kong's never had democracy.
I don't think that government is the answer to every problem, and I think most of my colleagues do, and I propose stories on free markets and free people doing things, and they just don't get it. ABC News, to their credit, has sometimes said, a boss has said to me, look, I don't agree with you, but this is an interesting intellectual idea, and it deserves to be on the air, and they put it on.
Intuition would suggest that countries with the most government planning, places where you're taken care of would be the best places to live. But the opposite's true. Countries with the most planning are the most poor. Several organizations rank countries by economic freedom. At one end are places with lots of government planning. Invariably, these are the worst places to live. And at the other end of the list, Hong Kong, New Zealand, Switzerland, the United States, the best places to live are the places with the fewest rules. Now, freedom isn't everything. Climate matters, religion, geography, even luck can make a difference. But nothing matters as much as liberty. That's our program for tonight. I'm John Stossel. Good night.
The media undoubtedly has a credibility problem today. Why is that? Are we headed the wrong way, or are we starting to improve, do you think?
I don't see much to be optimistic about. Thomas Jefferson said it's the natural progress of things for government to gain and liberty to yield. And I think that's the direction in which we're going. Every year, government gets bigger under Democrats and Republicans, and the press cheers it on.